Good evening once again. Welcome to our 4th of July celebration, our 4th of July parade here in Kailua, Kona Town.
The first entry that we're going to see are the banner carriers, and we welcome the parade banner carried by children who are members of Leilea Naopio, part of Kealakahi Neighborhood Watch. They attend Holualoa Elementary, Kealakahi Intermediate, and High School. For the past 6 years, members of the Kealakahi Neighborhood Watch have led the 4th of July parade.
Ladies and gentlemen, we ask that you stand to welcome the flag of our country. The U.S. flag is brought to us by the Kona Civil Air Patrol. Civil Air Patrol is a volunteer nonprofit auxiliary of the United States Air Force. Membership in the Civil Air Patrol is open to young men ages 12 through 17 and adults. Cadets and CAP proceed at their own pace through a 16-step program, paving the way for cadets to fly an airplane solo and become an aerospace leader in the future. The Civil Air Patrol.
The whole thing. And as you can hear, the next entry is the Hawaii County Fire Department. Engine number seven, our Kailua Kona District Fire Company. They provide fire, emergency medical, and other emergency services for Kailua Kona in responding to over 200 alarms per month, including dive rescue, ground search and rescue,
thanks, guys,
and rope rescue services to those in need of help. Welcome Captain Todd Vincent, Mike Kamu, Kyle Tevis, and Jamie Okuda in the medical unit.
I don't know if that horn works, though. Does that horn work? Nice, it does. Good. Let's say hazard and aloha to Life Care Center of Kona. How's it, guys? Life Care Center, celebrating independence, ensuring that each and every resident is treated with the dignity and respect that is guaranteed by the Residents' Bill of Rights. Yeah. Today, they're especially proud to recognize their residents who have served in the U.S. military. Thanks to these men and women for their brave service to our country. It is their drive and determination that keeps the independent spirit alive. Happy 4th from the residents and associates of Life Care Center, Kona. How's it, guys? We see you in there. There you are. How's it?
The next we're going to mention, we're going to notice the Boy Scouts of America Aloha Council. The Aloha Council is the largest council of the Boy Scouts and includes Kauai, Oahu, and Hawaii Island, as well as Guam and American Samoa. The Cub Scouts recently participated in a two-day Scout day camp, and the Boy Scouts recently returned from their week-long summer camp at Camp Honokaya, where they earned merit badges in cooking, orienteering, pioneering, wilderness, survival, and many other skills. Behind the boys are some of the support team that helped them achieve their badges.
Let's say good afternoon to Angel Pilago. Angel is a highly decorated Vietnam veteran, earning a Silver Star for heroism and two bronze for bravery while serving with the U.S. Army 101st Airborne Division. Angel served on a county council, including members as a county council member, 6 years, county council vice chair as well. Along with Angel is the Kealakehi Youth Crime Watch program with Auntie Elaine Watai. They keep Kealakehi safe and help feed the homeless at the Meet and Eat programs, Kealakehi Intermediate School. Oh, I see. You never like them fall off the truck, that's why. Oh, okay. Aloha. Our Grand Marshal Angel Pilago.
And here comes Auntie Elaine. Hey, Kealakehi Neighborhood Watch, major player.
You know, I feel proud that I have known this woman for many, many, many years, and how much she gives to the community is simply remarkable. Auntie Elaine, you are just an amazing person. I thank you so much for everything that you've done. Year in, year out, day after day after day after day.
You look great.
You're a blessing to the community. Thank you, Auntie.
And walking in the parade are Council Vice Chair Karen Eoff, Councilman Drew Mama Kanuha, and Margaret Willey, all County Council representatives from District 6, 7, and 8. District 8 is Karen Eoff, Vice Chair of the County Council. District 7 in Central Kona is Drew Kanuha, and District 9 is Margaret Willey. Aloha.
We're coming up in the County of Hawaii County Band. Oops. West Hawaii County Band, Lisa Archuleta, wishing the town of Kona a happy 4th. Comprised of more than 20 county and volunteer musicians, the band has a distinguished history, performing in concerts and parades throughout the Big Island for over 100 years. Guys, we're hearing more drumming than music, guys. Is there a way we can kind of, can we? 3, 4. Don, Mr. Don Isbell, if you can kind of crank up a sound here. Then. Here we go, all right. Yes, here we go.
And here comes Hawaii County, with all of their people walking in the parade. Please welcome, they're passing out American flags, Managing Director Wally Lau, Parks and Recreation Deputy Director Bob Fitzgerald, Elderly Activities Director Whirlan Okamura, Steve Arnett, Research and Development Laverne Amore, Mass Transit Tiffany Kai, Information and Technology, Don Jacobs, Planning Director, Dwayne Kanuha.
Steve, one flag, Steve, one flag, that's it? Dude, come, no candy, no nothing, Tootsie Rolls, I mean.
Aloha and mahalo for Mayor Billy Kanoi and the County of Hawaii, Ohana.
Giving the rest of them away.
Really?
Who's that?
This is the Regents.
Wow.
I think this is for when the county marchers get tired. They have a heli on bus.
Is this the new green bus? Don't we have a green fuel, whatchamacallit? Bus? No?
That's
sure looks nice.
Yeah.
You gotta fix the brakes on that thing. We're coming up in the great people of Regency at Hualalai. Residents and staff of Regency Hualalai, the ultimate in senior living. Residents at Regency Hualalai choose the level of care that best suits their needs and enjoys 3 meals a day, paid utilities, basic cable, weekly housekeeping, and linen service as well. Is Grandma Lee front and center here? How's it, Grandma? How are you? Happy birthday, 96, right? This past, yeah, 96. Congratulations. Delbert is driving you. You're in good hands because Delbert's driving. Regency at Hualalai, mahalo.
And here come the Shriners of Kona. They've marched in every 4th of July parade. Every year, they march to keep people aware of the Children's Burn and Orthopedic Hospitals, where children are treated totally free of cost. To learn about these hospitals, ask a Shriner. Happy birthday, America. God, I can't believe he's still blowing his pipes.
Oh, sir, I was just getting in. If you could just play a couple more bars, that'd be... I was just getting... Oh, okay, sorry. Where's your clown outfit this year? No clown outfit. Kona Shriners, thank you very much for being here.
Thank you.
why is the car named Soap? Just... you just drive. Right. Soap license plates. Okay, this must be a clean car. I won't feel
sorry. Take that one. Welcome Shan Tsutsui, the Lieutenant Governor of the State of Hawaii and the first Lieutenant Governor from the island of Maui. Shan is joined today by his wife, Lindell. They have three daughters. Shan is grateful for the opportunity to represent and serve all the people of Hawaii as the Lieutenant Governor. He would like to send a big mahalo to all of our military members and their families for their service and many sacrifices. Yeah. And welcome to Barbara Dalton, who's sitting in an air-conditioned car.
Let's say aloha to the Hawaii Army National Guard. National Guard, representing the Guard and staff are Sergeants Ben Fontes, Private J. Belog. Serve your country from the very shores you call home. Go to college or pick up transferable skills to improve your life. All of these are possible with the Hawaii Army National Guard.
And welcome now to the National Federation of the Blind. Coming up next is the West Hawaii chapter of the National Federation of the Blind. It's an organization of blind working for the blind. If you're dealing with vision loss of your own or a friend, relative, patient, or student, please contact us to learn more. We offer support and information. Happy Fourth from the National Federation of the Blind.
See me out on the town, and it looks like burning down.
Also joining us is Kona Community Hospital. But in my heart, I'm always proud to celebrate freedom with our community by participating in today's parade. Kona Community Hospital, 94-bed full-service acute care hospital. 24-hour emergency services, been serving West Hawaii since 1914. Participating today are hospital management, employees, and family. So who's running the hospital, folks?
The other guys.
Also marching volunteers from the Kona Community Auxiliary. They are friends and neighbors providing care that you can count on. Happy Independence Day from Kona Community Hospital.
Aloha Kona, it's the Geico Gecko, wishing you all a safe and happy Independence Day. Geico has been insuring Hawaii drivers for over 60 years and has more than 170 Hawaii employees from our ohana to yours. Happy 4th of July. Hello, Gecko.
The Geico Gecko. St. Michael's Church Youth Group, since the days of our first president, George Washington, to the present day, George Washington, Abraham Lincoln, and the Statue of Liberty, the Civil Uncle Sam have stood for wisdom, strength, courage, and freedom. To all the young and old, we invite you to remember these truths, to live by them. St. Michael's Church Youth Group. Nice job with the costumes, guys.
Nice job with George Washington and Abraham Lincoln on each side. Great one. Very good. Hospice of Kona is the next float, or the next group. Hospice of Kona celebrates freedom for each and every one of us and for our nation. It reminds us how fortunate we are to be able to make choices. The choice to allow Hospice of Kona to provide care, comfort, and compassion to those faced with life-limiting illnesses. Hospice of Kona represents increased freedom for patients and families, with more choices and support in more aspects of their lives during a time when it is most needed.
American Legion Kona Post 20. We ask that you once again please stand for our second color guard for the afternoon. Representing the American Legion are Antonio Gaspar, David Carlson, Steve Miller, and Arthur DeMessa. The American Legion Kona Post 20 meets the second Wednesday of each month, 6:30 p.m., Tashima's Restaurant. Their mission is to focus on service to our veterans, to their families, and to the communities as their number one priority.
And next, we welcome the Korean War veterans. They're being transported by a ME-5A2 Deuce World War II Korea and Vietnam era 2.5-ton truck driven by Kalima Brooks. The Korean War Veterans Association, West Hawaii, Chapter 279. The Army, Navy, Marines, Coast Guard, and the Air Forces who served in the Korean War will be celebrating the 60th anniversary of the Korean War. The signing of the armistice on July 27, 1953. We also prayed for the MIA and the POW who served and never made it back.
The Korean War Veterans Association, West Hawaii Chapter 279. Thank you for your service, sir. Thank you. We can leave this cart right here.
The Vet Center has been serving veterans and their families in Kona since 1988. Vet Centers provide quality care for veterans, families, and communities. The Vet Center are the people who in the VA who welcome home with honor the war veteran by providing readjustment counseling for a successful post-war adjustment. We serve our veterans with pride as they so served our country.
Vet Center. Thank you very much. Did you guys get in a round of golf today? You just took the cart. You forgot to return the cart. I just wanted to kind of remind you on that one, just in case they may be looking for it. Next, we have the Kona VA Clinic. Their motto is putting the veteran first. Their veterans and staff are wearing uniforms or colorful aloha attire representing their branch of service. They are dedicated to providing high quality health care to eligible veterans, including the new rural health services in Waimea and Ocean View. They put the veteran first by acknowledging their service and celebrate freedom because those who have served in our military. Behind the wheel is Navy veteran Bob Harbison. Kona VA Clinic.
Welcome the Disabled American Veterans Medical Transportation. To assist veterans who need a ride to their VA appointments, please call VA Community-Based Outreach Clinic to obtain information on how to arrange van transportation. Chapter 7 is proud to serve the veteran community. We are veterans assisting those who serve this great nation of free people. Thank you for all you do.
Here now was the Big Island Retired Military Association, Burma. This M37 weapons carrier is a Korean War era three-quarter ton truck owned by Gage Allen, who is presently serving on board the U.S. Coast Guard cutter Monroe, operating out of Kodiak Island, Alaska. Transporting members of the Burma Big Island Military Retired Military Association, they're made up of more than 100 retired military personnel and their spouses. The group strives to protect and preserve rights, benefits, and privileges of retired armed forces personnel.
And next we have the West Hawaii Community Health Center. It's a community-based organization which began in 2005 and today serves over 11,000 patients on Hawaii Island. The purpose is to make quality, comprehensive, and integrated health services accessible to all, regardless of their ability to pay. Services are culturally appropriate to promote community well-being through the practice of Malama Pono. What's special about West Hawaii Community Health Center is the aloha that patients receive from the providers and staff during their visits. Respect and care represents West Hawaii Community Health Center. And that's ex-councilman Pete Hoffman passing that thing.
West Hawaii National Parks is next. Experience the beauty and wonder of the national parks of West Hawaii. Hike historic sections of the Alakahakai National Historic Trail. Visit Kamehameha's War Temple, Pu'ukohola National Historic Site, or journey back to Pu'uhonua o Honaunau. The national parks of this country honor our heritage and history. The parks in West Hawaii perpetuate the learning and practice of the Hawaiian culture. Come visit national parks in West Hawaii, and you too could wear a cape like my friend there.
And nice, you can get a junior park ranger. And the next parade unit is Incense, of SEED program. Under the sponsorship of Mauna Kea Gardens, Incense is a youth mentoring after-school program promoting positive self-esteem, empowerment, and education through dance and art journaling. Every year, they accept teenagers 13 to 19, meeting three times a week to learn tribal-style dancing and do art projects. Tribal style is a group improvisational dance combining ethnic movement from Polynesia, North Africa, India, and Spain. Students create artwork with award-winning mixed media artist Stephanie Bolton. They invite you to see their latest artwork at their exhibit at Island Naturals up all this month.
MIAPOWKIA, missing in action, prisoner of war, killed in action, Vietnam veterans, my good buddy Earl Rigador and Clarence Medeiros, Jacob Medeiros as well, of J5 Asphalt and Excavating, honor our soldiers, missing in action, prisoners of war, and killed in action. The Vietnam Wall replica especially honors the memory and names of missing veterans such as Paul Graffy, the son of Paul Graffy and wife Avapuhi of Kailua Kona, and Vietnam killed in action, Lieutenant Kauhai Hao of Honaunau as well. The table that you see there is set in honor of MIA and POWs for their sacrifice for our country. Each item placed on this table symbolizes many things. The table is round to show everlasting concern. The tablecloth is white, symbolizing purity. The single rose in a vase reminds of the blood given, and the vase is tied to a yellow ribbon, a symbol of continued support.
The next float is military spouses. President Ronald Reagan declared May 23, 1984 as the first Military Spouse Day, which is now observed on the Friday before Mother's Day, to honor spouses of those who served in the Army, Navy, Marines, Air Force, and Coast Guard for their sacrifice of giving up their spouses during deployments. Military spouse Shirley Calhoun made that ultimate sacrifice. Her husband's name, Lieutenant John Kawaihao, is found on the Vietnam Wall, and the Hawaii legislature recently passed a resolution to lobby Congress to support his receipt of the Congressional Medal of Honor. We honor her and all the military spouses and family members. The military spouses leave you with this message. We are caring family. Our soldier has gone to war. Our minds are filled with worries that we have never known before. From the killing fields of Vietnam to the bloody sands of Iraq, may we be scared, but we are proud. Our soldiers have got your back.
Happy 4th to all from the Hillway County Democratic Party. Special guests include County Chair Dave Tarnas, Congresswoman Colleen Hanabusa, Tulsi Gabbard, Senator Brian Schatz, and State Senators Josh Green and Malama Solomon. They remind us that liberty and justice for all is still the goal for all Americans. I'm afraid it's too late
on the giant. It's too late. Hey, you. Hey, you. What's up? What's up? It's too late on the giant. It's too late. Facebook and all that.
Aloha, Tulsi.
Hey, Senator Green.
Hey, you.
It's too late for the Giants. It's too late. I said it's too late for the Giants. It's too late.
Representative Colleen Hanabusa, back from Washington for a while. State Senator Malama Solomon, up in the white hat, the truck.
How you doing, Patty? You should be driving. You gotta work. You gotta work your way up through this, you know. Your lipstick stain
on the front of my left side. And the next group is Dolphin Journeys with Captain Nancy aboard the Dolphin TLC. No, you're not Dolphin Journeys. Oh, sorry. Okay, the next group then is Daughters of the American Revolution. Hawaii Lower Chapter, the Daughters of the American Revolution is a non-political organization dedicated to historic preservation and educating students and citizens about the Constitution by providing materials and support to schools and setting up Constitution Week displays in libraries. They promote patriotic activities through financial support to the State Veterans Home in Hilo, honoring veterans and handing out American flags on national holidays, like the 4th of July. Meetings are held around the island every 2 months and new members are welcome.
We'd like to welcome Ms. Bill Fish and HIBT founder Peter Fithian. Miss Billfish will greet anglers and her winning smile each day during the 54th Hawaiian International Billfish Tournament happening right here, Kailua Kona Pier, next month, August 5th through the 10th. HIBT inviting everyone to come to the pier on Sunday the 4th for the opening ceremony celebration. Starting at 3 p.m., the tournament kicks off on the pier with a great celebration, food, crafts, entertainment, and formal introduction of each team and their international flag and anthem.
And that's Mrs. Fithian driving the car. The Kona Outlaw Roller Girls are a family-oriented team, mothers and professional women who have come together for the love of roller derby. The team exists to provide an opportunity for women to participate in the challenging and exciting sport of roller derby. They strive to improve individual athleticism, self-discipline, and character while promoting team unity. They are inspired by the motto hailed throughout the country, by the skater for the skaters. They are always looking for new energetic recruits to join their team. No prior skating experience is necessary. You can check them out on Facebook or at their practice at the Old A's hockey rink on Mondays and Thursdays in the evening.
We say hello and aloha to Advocats. They're a nonprofit organization dedicated to the well-being of Hawaii Island's homeless felines. They believe in trap, neuter, return as the humane and most effective way to control the population of feral and homeless cats. Under the program, the feral cats are trapped, spayed, or neutered so they can no longer reproduce. Then they are returned to their colonies where they are cared for by dedicated Advocats volunteers. Advocats establish control colonies of sterilized cats at shopping centers, resorts, parks, and condominium complexes throughout West Hawaii. Advocats.
And here comes the Camp Tararua Detachment, 1255 Marine Corps League. Please stand for the Camp Tararua Detachment Color Guard. The Color Guard members are Kathy Payton, carrying the American flag, honoring all families that have lost family members while serving in our armed services. Carrying the Marine Corps flags, Sergeant Scott New, currently serving with the 2nd Battalion Island Warriors, 3rd Marine Regiment. The riflemen are veterans Bob Strickland and Frank Castangetti. The Camp Tararua Detachment is dedicated to preserving the history of the old Camp Tararua and the U.S. Marines and the U.S. Navy Corps that trained here during World War II. In the convertible are members of Camp Tararua Detachment, Camp Tararua Foundation, docents, and First Lieutenant James Pyle, currently serving with the 2nd Marine Battalion and the 3rd Marine Regiments. We've got PTA. 38.
Pohakuloa Training Area, first used during World War II as a Marine Corps artillery training area. U.S. Marines from the 2nd and 5th Marine Divisions trained at PTA in preparation for the Iwo Jima and Saipan campaigns. Today, PTA stands as the premier military training area in the Pacific region. In support of the local community of soldiers, Marines, and staff from PTA, they conduct numerous community service projects to include outplanting at West Hawaii Veterans Cemetery, assisting the Habitat for Humanity. They do local food drives and support the Boy Scouts, Civil Air Patrol, Hawaii Youth Challenge, and various public schools as well. Thank you very much, Pohakuloa Training Area.
Curtis Tyler is driving the Jeep, and Colonel Schwedo is the commander at Pohakuloa right now. Making their second appearance, let's welcome the Veterans of Foreign Wars, post 12122. The Veterans of Foreign Wars is the oldest veteran organization, having been established in 1899. The Kona branch is named in memory of our own 18-year-old Marine Lance Corporal Christopher Camaro, who gave his life fighting for his country. Driving the blue convertible down there is Wayne Gray, post commander. They're followed by a veteran war area M151 Jeep. The post is seeking new members. Their biggest challenge is to reach out to veterans and provide help for them and their spouses and their families.
Can you guys see what's coming up next? They're coming around the corner. They look like from a Toy Story, yeah? What were they called? The soldiers from that movie Toy Story?
No, they're all comic book heroes. They're all superheroes.
want you so to admire, cause you shine something like a mirror, and I can't help but notice you reflect.
All right, we're coming up on the superheroes of Auto Body Hawaii. Coming up, their award-winning performance in the Christmas Parade, Auto Body Hawaii. This year, celebrating their 40th anniversary. Started back in 1973 with one employee, Auto Body Hawaii has grown with our community in 1973 to today. Auto Body Hawaii would like to thank you for 40 years of support and wish all of you a safe Independence Day. There they are, the superheroes. Wonder Woman, Superman, Flash Gordon, Iron Man, and Despicable Me. No. Incredible Me. Yeah. All right.
That doesn't look like the little red wagon that I used to have. Look at this. What is that?
41.
That's a robot. And here comes the Coast Guard Auxiliary Flotilla, which looks to me like a robot. The U.S. Coast Guard Auxiliary was established by Congress in 1939. There are 30,000 members who are semper paratus, which means always ready. Vessel safety checks, oh, harbor patrols, safe boating courses, search and rescue, marine environmental protection are just a few of the services provided by the auxiliary. Each year, auxiliary volunteers more than 2 million hours nationwide. Their tugboat's name is Coastie. Say hello to Coastie and get him to bat your eyes at you.
Next, we have the U.S. Coast Guard Auxiliary Flotilla, established by Congress in 1939. Currently, 30,000 members who are semper paratus, which means always ready. Vessel safety checks, harbor patrols, safe boarding courses, search and rescue, and marine environmental protection are just a few of the services provided by the auxiliary. Each year, auxiliarists volunteer more than 2 million hours nationwide, benefiting boaters and their families.
Our next entry is Brenda Ford, who is the current council member for District 6, which contains part of North Kona, South Kona, Kau, and the Greater Volcano Area. Piloting in the car is Brenda's husband, Larry Ford, with Doug Ray as the co-pilot. Riding in the car with Brenda is her staff, Deborah Ka'iliwai Ray and Lorena Call, her two right hands. They wish everyone a happy 4th of July.
We also have the Zulu Dancers. Zulu Dancers from Los Angeles, California, taught by Crystal Castillo and Spidey, whom both devoted to enriching the lives of children through dance. Hip-hop, breakdance, and the history of hip-hop are taught to boys and girls ages 6 through 18. Zulu Dance strives to show every child the true meaning of hip-hop, which is peace, love, unity, and having fun. They're hosting a one-hour workshop free for kid ages 5 through 12 years of age this Saturday, West Hawaii Dance Theater.
Here comes Island-Wide Solar. Have you been thinking about the money you could save by going green? If so, then let Island-Wide Solar, a locally owned company, provides you with fast, friendly, and efficient service statewide that you can count on. We also have leasing options for your convenience. So let us provide you the solar freedom you deserve.
Wow.
See, just like solar, they keep coming and coming and coming. They always provide energy and electricity.
Don't forget, fireworks show at 8 o'clock tonight right in Kailua Bay. Invite you to please join us for that. And also thank the many people who made that possible. A lot of donations came in to make tonight's show possible. So I'd like to thank all the supporters and sponsors and everybody who helped out. Looking forward to tonight's fireworks display at 8 o'clock.
Just to let you know.
Hi, Dolphin Journeys. We were expecting you earlier, but that's okay. We'll take you now. We're just glad you're here. You have a beautiful, beautiful float decoration here. It looks very nice. What's puppy's name? Taylor. Oh, Sailor. Yeah. Hi, Sailor. Sailor's very much in the spirit there.
And here comes West Hawaii Today. They celebrate the birth of this great nation and the freedom of the press that allows them to provide local, national, and global news to West Hawaii. Parents, pick up a copy of today's edition for a 4th of July coloring book and encourage your keiki to color their favorite picture and drop it off at West Hawaii Today to be entered in a coloring contest.
Let's welcome the Filipino Americans of West Hawaii, led by President Benimar Sadumiano and 2013 Filipino Americans of West Hawaii Fiesta Queen Susanna Afaga Aurora. The Filipino Americans work for young people to help people get through high school, including tutoring. They also want to set good examples with their involvement in service, ministry, and leadership opportunities, and create a youth-friendly community. They also help members of the Filipino community by helping in family celebrations, assisting families when a family member passes. Filipino Americans also working to preserve their culture heritage with dance, costumes, and much more. Filipino Americans of West Hawaii.
Jackie Ray's Ohana Grill has been serving the Kona community with great food for the past 9 years. Jackie Ray's is a big community supporter, feeding over 750 people Thanksgiving dinners every year in conjunction with the Salvation Army. Come to Jackie Ray's for old-fashioned island hospitality, and I happen to know personally that he's going to do a big remodel very soon.
We have now the Unitarian Universalists of West Hawaii. In a new church in Kailua Kona with roots in the founding of America, they celebrate freedom with open heart, open arms, and open minds. They seek to make meaning, make connections, and make a difference as well. Celebrating freedom with the seven principles, you're invited to visit on the second and fourth Sundays, 4 p.m. Kona Outdoor Circle, or go to their website, uuwesthawaii.com.
And here comes Kona Echo Adventures. Experience Kona's first and only zipline tour adventure with Kona Echo Adventures. Your adventure begins at check-in at their retail shop in the Keho Shopping Center, and then shuttle to Hokokono Ranch, where you will soar from tree to tree. 8 exhilarating zip lines, 2 suspension bridges, snack and beverages in our Ohia hut. Also offering ATV tours and nature hikes.
Finally, we got some candy this afternoon. How about a nice ad for KB Extreme? Kona's local bowling alley, bar, restaurant, arcade, karaoke located Central Kailua, 9 a.m. to 2 a.m. 2 a.m. 2 a.m. Did you say 2 a.m.? What time? 2 a.m. All right, you sure? All right. They got coupon giveaways and much more. Check out KB Extreme.
Superior Sanitation is a family-owned and operated business serving Kona since 2004. Superior Sanitation provides commercial front-load trash service as well as roll-off services. They also provide a cardboard recycling route, helping to keep Kona clean and green. With both friends and family, past and present, serving in our armed forces, Mike and Angela of Superior Sanitation would like to thank our service members and their families for their courage and dedication while producing our freedom. Happy 4th of July.
Middleman, Middleman. Middleman is approaching, keeping a sharp eye out on us humanoids. Bucky, you sure you want to be driving the Middleman? A pair of eyes in paradise, they come in peace and bring you all a present of insightful music. Are they looking out for us?
Is that Hocus Pocus lifting up that small child? So remind us how special Keiki and we all are. He's available for parties and events. 54.
Echo City Knockouts, dedicated to promoting athleticism, good sportsmanship, and female empowerment through the sport of women's flat track roller derby. Echo makes 3 years this month. We'd like to wish them a very happy birthday and look forward to cheering them on July 20th when they battle an Oahu team at the old airport. They are recruiting as well. So happy Independence Day from the Echo City Knockouts.
Hawaii Volunteer Fire Company 7 Bravo, concluding. Concluding our parade is our volunteer Fire Company 7 Bravo, which is 15 member strong fire company based in Palisades under the direction of Captain John Birch and Assistant Captain Chad Kinney. Bravo is on call, serving the west side of the island 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. The Kailua Kona Independence Day Parade and Fireworks Committee says a big mahalo to the Kona community. Thanks for everybody for watching the 18th annual Kailua Kona Independence Day Parade. See you at the fireworks tonight at 8 p.m. Be sure to turn on your radio to Lava 105 and say goodbye to the whale, too. If you haven't had enough, you'll be able to watch the parade and fireworks on Maleo, Hawaii, Channel 53, beginning next week.
sing it something like this. Listen here.
Come to America.
night when we laid down our heads. My daddy served in the army. We lost his right eye, but he flew a flag out in our yard. Till the day that he died, he wanted my mother, my brother, my sister and me to grow up and live happy in the land of the free. Now this nation that I love is falling under attack. A mighty sucker punch came flying in from somewhere in the back. As soon as we could see it clearly through our big black eye, man, we lit up your world like the 4th of July. Hey, Uncle Sam, put your name at the top of his list, and a statue of